Hi, Sibelle.
Hello.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, everyone.
So, Sibelle, today we are going to be discussing a very, very interesting topic, a very disturbing topic, actually. What is the topic, Sibelle, that you wanted to talk about today?
Dealing with domestic violence in the time of Corona.
Yes, so it's domestic abuse. It's also how this domestic abuse and violence, how it's on the rise during the lockdown. It's a very hard topic to deal with, yet we will do our best to talk and to cover everything about it. So, Sibel, to tell everybody about you so that they meet you and the beautiful person that you are. Sibel is a certified hypnotherapist and she's been seeing clients and having very, very successful results. And also, Sibel is now completing her nursing studies at AUB, and very soon she will be graduating as well and then pursuing other studies, of course. Would you like to add something about that, Sibel?
I think this is everything.
All right, and if I ask you to describe yourself as a person, how would you?
Actually, I would only describe myself with one word. It's ambitious. Because, under it's a huge umbrella and it falls under it a lot of things, ambitious, it means covering my career life, my personal life, and my social life. So I'm ambitious be my social life. Like, I love people, I love to have interactions with people, communication with people, try to know people, try to learn from them, and I'm always curious to meet people and to get to know them. In my personal life, a kid with my family, with my relationships, I try my best to reach a place where it's very, to maintain, or to reach a place where everything is great. I cannot say everything is great, but the
Balance,
well-being,
let's
balance,
say.
yes,
Of
totally.
course, this is lovely. This is lovely. Yeah.
And my career, because I'm always learning, I always want to learn new things, I always want to improve myself, and that's everything.
You
So I would
are
say that.
definitely on the learner path, which is a beautiful thing about you. You have an inquisitive mind, Sibel. So, when we are to start discussing, of course, I'm really getting a lot of complaints, I'm in lockdown with my abuser. So if we are really to discuss abuse or domestic abuse, its definition, its kinds, what would it be?
So basically, abuse, the word abuse, it means someone who practiced some threats on you on purpose, leaving you with physical and psychological damage. Under the umbrella of abuse, we have different types. We have verbal abuse, العنف اللغوي عندنا، الفيزيكال ابيوز، العنف الجسدي عندنا، السكشوال ابيوز، العنف الجنسي، وعندنا الايموشنال ابيوز، العنف المعنوي، واخر شيء عندنا النيجلاكت which is التخلي عن الشخص. So all of these are under the category of abuse. So one of the things that I want to stress on انه اذا الشخص
Yes.
إذا الشخص مش إنه إنه ما ما بيمارس العنف كجسديا، مش يعني هو منه عم بعنف. So it's very essential for us to know that الحكي، الكريتيسيزم، البليم، الكونتينيوس بليم اند كريتيسيزم، اوف كورس it is an abuse. Even sexual abuse كمان باللوك داون it's very common.
Right.
وكمان الابيوز مش بس على البارتنرز، يعني child abuse is very common also and parental
كمان
abuse when it comes if, especially if our parents they are elderly now you know with this corona thingy and especially in Lebanon we have like financial crisis and people are losing their jobs so the elderly are facing with neglect abuse.
صح سبال كتير مهمين كل النقط يلي قلتيهم لأنه نحن هدفنا كتير بهيدا الفيديو نوعي so it's an educational video كتير مهم نرجع شوي نسلط الضوء على كم شغلة هلأ فإذا هيدا الأبيوز it can happen to everyone يلي نحن عم نفهمه من سبال هلأ إنه it can happen للصغير it can happen للكبير هو عادة سبال the majority أكيد is against girls and women بالأخص بالمجتمع العربي وفإذا كمان هيدا الأبيوز بصير بكل الرجز بكل الريسز عادة in general 85% من الأبيوزرز are men بنفس الوقت هول المن ممكن أكيد يكونوا كمان كتير أذكياء كتير حساسين كتير رومانتك وهيدا الشيء اللي عادة بتكون تنقول الصبية يلي مع هيدا الرجال بتكون اندينايل لفترة طويلة على أساس انه هو هالقد ذكي هالقد حساس هالقد رومانتك وبالأخص انه بأول ستيج من علاقتهم بيكون هو كتير about seduction about he wants to seduce her he is very charming with her وبنفس الوقت كتير بحط جهد انه يبين لها يحسسها انه هي الدوميننت دوميننت بارتنر انه هي يلي دايما بتاخد القرارات بيرجع لها دايما بالقرارات فهيدي اول ستيج كمان مثل كانه it puts the defenses down of the woman ولبعدين مع الوقت بصير هلأ منرجع يعني بسياق الحديث منحكي عن stage 2 و stage 3 لبال ما يصير الابيوز او الفيولنس يلي اوقات ممكن يودي للمردر فكمان بدنا نقوله انه هيدا الابيوز اكيد من قبل مثلا كانوا عم بيسلطوا الضوء بال WHO واليون وهيك على الفيولنس يلي بصير بالورك بليس صح تتذكر بل من فترة كثير تركز على الابيوز اللي بصير in the workplace احنا كثير اخترنا lockdown نشوف من وراء هلأ هيدا lockdown موجودين بالبيت arguments ضرب والأشخاص ما عندها محل تهرب ما هي صح انه ومثل ما انت قلتي ونرجع منشدد انه في physical في moral في psychological في emotional وفي sexual وبعدين هلأ شو برأيك أنت الفاكتورز يلي بيودوا للأبيوز شو هن الفاكتورز يلي بيودوا لهيدا الفايولنس أو الأبيوز
So basically someone who is abusive or violent هو هيدا الشخص already بيكون بحياته معرض ل this type of act So it's not someone who developed it. So he sensed it, يعني. So حتى violence, abusers, you can actually predict their behavior. So مش واحد out of the blue, he will come and just unleash this side, you know.
هلا
For sure he is manipulative.
يعني ممكن يكون معرض هو معرض لأبيوز من his childhood ممكن تكون الشغلة in his genes ممكن هو يكون وارد هيدي البيهيفير من حدا من عائلته، من بيو، من جده مثلا، هل هيدا الشيء ممكن سبال؟
Yes, yes, of course. You know, لأنه حتى هذا الشخص who is practicing abuse, let's say in a house وعنده children, even if this abuse is not towards his children, but his children are actually witnessing. So for sure they're going to grow older and they will have this image that, you know, this is normal and this is okay if I treat my wife like that or my girlfriend like that. So this is one case. And the second case, which is with the genes, so everything that we already practice and our behaviors, everything will be imprinted in our genes, everything will be imprinted in our biology, and therefore we will pass this throughout our generations and to our offspring. So sometimes someone like, you know, who مش بإيده and he is born with it, it's a truth,
yes,
because it passed through his this generation. So this is one. Two, another factor, of course.
Very important topic, yes.
Second factor is, of course, يعني lockdown لوحده, it is stressful. يعني الشخص لحتى يترك شغله, لحتى يجي يقعد بالبيت, هيدي it's a major change, يعني. بطل في عنده الزلمة, let's say, or المرأة, بطل في عندهم تنفيسة. So everything بالبيت, بالبيت. بطل حتى يعني يحكي مع العالم outside. So هيدا كله stress زايد على حياته. Especially كمان عنا بلبنان, on top of that, we have this financial issues. So في عالم they
actually... The economic pressure.
Yes. So في عالم they lost their job. So كمان هيدا an extra stressor. في عالم عندهم أولاد, والولاد بيتطلبوا. كمان an extra stressor. So كلهم هودي بيخلوا الواحد to accumulate هالخبار وهالقصص. And eventually... صح. He needs to, you know, the bucket will be filled. So,
full.
Absolutely. بيطلع through abusive act.
كانت عم شوف سيبال انه بمارتش actually 48 cases بلبنان have been reported, واكيد انه عم بيكون في اكثر حالات, بس لانه again في خوف انه اذا انا جيت اليوم اتصلت وين بدي روح, لانه في لوك داون, بطل هيدا اللوك داون مثلا عم يسمح للصبيه تنقول تروح عند اختها او عند حدا من اصحابها. فلهالسبب انا بظن في كثير اشخاص منهم عم يسترجوا تو ريبورت شو عم بصير معهم, بس يلي عملوا ريبورتينج بمارش كانوا 48 كيسز. وشو بعد يعني بدنا نقول من ناحية الـ percentages؟ مثلا بأمريكا في عنا 1 in 3 American women, يعني imagine they are abused. وأنا مثلا اليوم كنت عم بتمشى حوالي البيت وعايشة يعني بمنطقة يعني فينا نقول أكيد مرتبة, وكان في صبية كمان عم تتمشى وفي صار مسيو على الموتو صار انه يجي ويحشى ويحكي معه. ف what about stalking, is it also كمان شو ما هيك من هيدا الشيء كمان عم بصير على الطرقات عنا بلبنان, الستوكينج والتحرش؟
Of course, it falls under it, لأنه بمجرد we are invading the privacy of someone else without taking their consent لحاله, it's an assault, you know. Another type كمان هلأ, بما أنه ذكرني أنه في كتير cases that are not being reported, في type of isolation, يعني their partner might be isolating them from social media, from talking to their family, from talking to their friends. So this كمان is an actual abuse.
Absolutely. في كتير types of abuse عم بتصير. بعدين دايما إذا نحنا بدنا معي أكثر, مثل ما أنا قلت إنه في يعني إذا بدنا نسألنا نطرح هيدا السؤال اليوم إنه ليش المرأة بتقبل تبقى بالبيت طالما هي عارفة لأنه number one وأكثر بيكونوا denial, number two لأنه هن ما بيكونوا actually عارفين إنه هيدا الشيء abuse, بيكونوا هن مفكرين نوعا ما إنه part of the world ممنوع ولا رجال to embarrass her, to insult her, to control what she does. بالأخص ونحن عايشين بعالم عربي كنيسي, فالمرأة هون بتفكر إنه it is normal إنه الرجال إنه to control her أو يجي يسألها مع مين أنت عم تتصلي, مع مين عم تحكي, أو لوين مثلا رحتي, أو بيطلع مثلا فيها بيعبس بوجهها, أو مثلا it is normal نوعا ما إنه الرجال يكون هو عنده الكنترول على المال, مش حتى لو هي عم تشتغل. في عندك كتير رجال بيتوقعوا انه at the end of the month بيتوقعوا من المرة تبعهم انه تقولهم تفضل يا رجال هيدا هو معاشي كل اخر شهر, وبتفكر انه هيدا الشيء هي نورمال. في عندك كمان بمجتمعنا انه الرجال هو بياخد كل القرارات, وكمان هون بتفكر انه المرأة انه نورمال انه الرجال ياخد قرارات بلا ما يستشيرني مثلا. سو هيدا كلياته نحن منحب نوعي اليوم انه هيدا كلياته form of abuse. أكيد كمان زيادة في عنا استعمال الغنز, استعمال النايفز, عنا أكيد زيادة الخنق مثلا, بيكونوا عم يتخانقوا, بمد إيده عليها بيضربها بيخنقها.
كمان في
شغلة,
I was reading an article كمان بأمريكا, she's a survivor, عم بتقول إنه حتى جوزها her abuser استفاد من situation of كورونا. He actually threatened her, هددها إنه إذا بتسألي بالبيت أنا شاحتك. So كمان التهديد is something.
التهديد is something very big, والخطورة كمان إنه أوقات سيبال أنا كمان إنه لأنه بتعرفي إنه I'm a specialist in psychiatry كمان mental health nursing. So وقتها بيكون في عنا كمان narcissistic personality. فبالnarcissistic personality وفي عنا كتير الgaslighting هون بيلعب دور كتير قوي, إنه مثلا بيجي من بعد ما يخنقها أو من بعد ما يضربها بيجي بيقلها لو ما انت you triggered me انا ما كنت مثلا مديت ايدي عليك او خنقتك يعني. فدايما they find a way in narcissistic personality انه يقلبوا الحديث تيرجع to blame the partner, مثل كأنه منقول نحن بالعربي انه دايما بلاقي طريقة يسحب حاله مثل الشعرة من العجينة. Exactly. So, هون لازم عن جد, وبتمنى أنا على الكل يلي عم يسمعونا أنه يعرفوا this is a disorder and this is not normal behavior. يعني وقتها بيجي البارتنر بيهدد أنه أنا بدي انتحر أو أنا بدي أقتل حالي إذا أنت بتضلك عم تعملي هيك مثلا, لا يعني هيدا الشيء منه مقبول, and you shouldn't really take it lightly, you should report it. وهلأ نحن كمان بنرجع عم نحكي إنه شو فينا نعمل, لمين فينا نتصل. هلأ أنا كمان كنت عم بحكي عن أول ستيج, ما هيك قلنا إنه أول ستيج بصير في charm, بصير في seduction. هلأ عادة يلي بعدين بصير إنه بده هو مثل ما قلنا انه ياخذ القرارات, وبيرجع اخر شيء بيوصل انه بهدد بده يقتل. فهيدا اذا هو عم يلعبها بطريقه انه عم بخطط هو كيف بده يعني يتغير بتصرفاته معه. Exactly. Yeah. عندنا شيء هوت لاين نحن بلبنان للدوميستيك فايولنس وابيوز؟
يس, عندنا 3 actually NGOs as far as I know. يعني عندنا حماية, عندنا أبعاد, عندنا كفا. هول كلهم they are doing a great job يعني, especially throughout this quarantine عم يعملوا a lot of awareness campaigns بهيدا الموضوع.
صح, كتير صح. أنا كفا I know them personally, يعني they have consulted with me, و I I teach them self-care. I teach the social workers there who work. It's an amazing NGO. Actually, كتير كتير يعني عم يشتغلوا. Wow, they are receiving calls وأكثر من حيلا وقت قبل من قبل يعني. فنحن basically كتير بهمنا أنه نقول أنه في عنا الهوت لاين الـ 1745 هيدا للـ security forces هني عملوا هيدا الهوت لاين with the help of كفا وعنا كمان أكيد الهلب لاين تبع كفا يلي هو 760-990-10 so أكيد نحن منشجع كل الناس يلي عم يسمعونا أكيد they can reach out to us for sure بس من ناحية كdomestic violence هو الهوتلاين والهلبلاين they can directly contact them and they will receive the help they need حتى بزمن الكورونا فيروس يعني ما يحطوا excuses إنه لأنه نحن هلأ بالكورونا ما حدا رح يسمع لنا أو ما حدا رح يساعدنا لا بالعكس يعني بأول ما صار حتى اللوك داون كفى استجابوا لشي 75 calls يعني استجابوا وساعدوا النساء ويعني it's really very important to reach out وخلص يعني هيدا silence نحط له حد يعني ودايما أنا بقول إنه الabuse thrives in silence so وقتا نحنا منجي منحط السبوتلايت عليه ومنحكي عليه ومنحكي عنه ومنحكي مثل ما هلأ عم نعمل هيدا الشيء أكيد بده يعني يخفف الأبيوز وأنا بتمنى على الناس اللي عم يسمعونا to share this video with as many people as possible وإن شاء الله يعني we will be able to decrease the rate فكنا عم نقول سيبال انه we covered most of the important points very important points so thank you كتير على ال precautions والtips كمان يلي عطيتينا اياها اليوم وشو رأيك ننهي السيشن ب هيك مثل hypnotherapy session mini session هيك about protection about safety Do you think you will like to?
Sounds great.
Okay, so let us do it. So let's start by the progressive muscle relaxation to release all tension and stress from the lockdown. So I invite you to make yourself comfortable if you want to go back a bit or move your shoulders a bit. Close your eyes. And start taking deep breaths. Inhale and exhale. And as you are inhaling and exhaling, feel how all of your body is relaxing completely. Scan your body and notice where there is some tension. Is this tension in your upper body or is it in your lower body? Is this tension in the left side of your body or in the right side of your body? The moment you start focusing on this tension, allow yourself to relax this tension completely. And with every inhalation, feel how the oxygen is going straight to that tense area, turning it into softness and relaxation. Allow my voice to guide you deeper and deeper into relaxation. And if you are hearing other noises in the background, allow those noises to even blend into this hypnotic trance. Even if you move your hand, any body movement at all will help you relax deeper and deeper. So now that all of your body is relaxed, focusing on your chest, relax your chest. Focus on your stomach muscles, relax your stomach muscles. Focus on your legs, on your knees, relax them. Notice how you are very, very relaxed now, much more than a few moments ago when we just started. And it feels so good. In a few moments, I will count from 1 to 10. And as I'm counting from 1 to 10, you will deepen the level of relaxation that you are already feeling. Before I count, I wonder if you can imagine yourself in a very happy place. It might be a vacation destination that you went to before, or it might be a place in nature, or it might even be in your own home. Wherever your mind is going, allow it to be there. Allow yourself to be in a place where you feel so happy, peaceful, confident. Be there as I start counting. One, deeper and deeper relaxed with every number. Two, more and more relaxed. Three, deepening the level of relaxation. Four, notice the sounds around you. Notice if you are there alone or with others. Notice the temperature there. Go there. Be there. Notice what you're wearing. Five, deeper. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10, deep, deep, deep relaxation. You are now very relaxed and you are now very peaceful. Allow yourself to stay there for a few moments. And as you are there, I'd like you to imagine a protective shield surrounding you. It can be your own protective bubble. Within this shield, you feel so safe, so comfortable, even much more than what you were already feeling. You can even give it a color, or it can be like a second skin. Within this protective shield, you are a totally positive being, and the uses of this shield are limitless. It can now start filter out all negative emotions, all negative thoughts that you have been feeling from the beginning of the lockdown, even from before. Start imagining and witnessing how all the negativity is being filtered out. As you are detaching from it, notice how your body is feeling. Notice the sensations in your body, how they are shifting. Notice the temperature in your extremities, while always focusing on taking your deep breaths. This shield, the more you use it, the stronger it becomes, just like a muscle. So in a few moments, I will count from 5 to 1. And when I say 1, you will awaken, feeling so energetic, yet so relaxed. So relaxed, yet alert. Feeling so confident, so safe, so secure. And those feelings will remain with you. And every time you think of the protective shield, every time you close your eyes and feel how you are feeling now, this will be activated and reinforced. And you can also wake up every morning with the thought, every day in every way, I feel safer and safer. Every day in every way, my protective shield is becoming stronger and stronger. So every time you think of the protective shield during your days, it will be reactivated again, even stronger. Five, starting to come back to the here and the now. Four, feeling much better than when we just started. Three, you can start to move your arms and legs. Two, feeling so blessed, so relaxed. And one, eyes open. How do you feel, Sibelle?
I feel wonderful. Amazing.
Fantastic. Fantastic. I hope as well that everybody who is listening, I hope they also decided to take this time with you as well. And is there, tell me, is there some numbness in your body, some heaviness or tingling?
Yes, of course. I did my extremities, actually they went numb. I felt like I'm light, as if I'm floating above the couch.
Yes.
حتى هلا يعني I'm talking to you. حس حالي إنه so relaxed.
And what do we tell the people who also practiced this session with us? Shuman alone, that those signs are
very normal. You experience is normal.
وبيروحوا بعد كم دقيقة بعد شي 5 دقايق بيروحوا وهني they are excellent signs of actually being relaxed and exactly
letting go.
Excellent indication.
It's amazing how عن جد brief moments of hypnosis how يعني they shift your mood, they shift your perception بشكل كتير major.
Ah, that's so true, and we know it, we use it, and its effects are spectacular. And even if we do it for a few minutes, not necessarily إنه السيشن بدها تكون ساعة أو ساعة ونص مش بالضرورة, and the effects are quite very positive and long-lasting.
Strong.
Thank you, Sibelle.
Yes.
It's really,
thank
really.
You.
Thank you for sharing space. It's been wonderful. وإن شاء الله منضلنا عم نعمل كمان educational videos مشان نفيد قد ما فينا من العالم. Kindly comment and share this video.
Definitely.
All right.
Thank you. Have a great
thank
day.
Thank you. You too.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.